Welcome to the Entrepreneur Mind Podcast, where transform your mindset from consuming to producing. I'm your host, Zen Flint. Hello everyone, thanks for listening. This is Zen Flint. So why do you want to become an entrepreneur? Is that because you want to have a flexibility? Is this your dream to own a business? Who is an entrepreneur?
My definition of entrepreneur is a person who organizes and manages a venture or a business, takes the calculated risk and full responsibility for the outcome. As an entrepreneur, I believe we have to be able to see things differently. You have to change your mentality from being a consumer to a person who will be a producer. You have to create stuff. You have to come up with the solutions to the problem. You have to create something out of nothing. There is two types of entrepreneurs. One is want to change the world, come up with a new product, they jump the curve, shift the paradigm, something totally new, never been explored and invented. So they go after that. And there's another type is they will already see what's on the market, what's doing good or bad, and then they try to evaluate the market, come up with something better. They do better than the other people, other competition. So they will try to build a product around that. So the real question is, are you doing it for money? Because, yeah, I think money is important, but if they have a meaning, you have to ask yourself questions like, what money will do for me? Are you really after the money that just piece of paper? No, you have to create better meaning for that. What money will do for me instead of what I will do for the money? You see, when I say what money can buy or do for me, it's a lot more inspiring and has a lot more meaning instead of what I'm willing to do for the money. When you concentrate on money, I think it's not enough motivation to accomplish something. You have to try to impact the people, their lives, impact your family. I mean, you at least try to come up something will improve somebody's lives because of your business or your service or the product. You can impact on many aspects of different people's, different companies, to the world as well. So I think it's important to remember that. Why most people never, even they have ideas, but there is a lot of people who has ideas, but not most of them end up pursuing those ideas. And main reason is a fear of failure. And I think it's important to remember that. Don't be afraid. What to lose? I mean, what you gonna lose? Everything is gonna be temporary. Nothing lasts forever. One day, even your life will gone. And looking back, when you get old, all you can is think about this, what you have done different, okay? Or if you ask yourself question, looking back, if I want to change, what would be? And you know what most people answer to that question is not, they don't regret the things they have done. Mostly people regret about things they had a chance to take opportunity, but they never did. And I think that's why when you have idea or goal, you have to try to accomplish it. And mostly people stop because of a fear of failure. And I can give you one small advice on that. If you fail, you're gonna just learn a lot from that experience. And if you look back, all the great inventors, entrepreneurs, they all failed hundreds, thousands times. And they kept going, they believed in themselves, they found the courage within themselves, pull all the string that they had, all the strength, and they're able to pull it off because they never gave up. Thomas Edison, he tests his experiment over 1,000 times before he come up with a light bulb. Co-writer of Chicken Soup for the Soul series, he was rejected over 100 times before he got published. I mean, this just goes on and on, and I think the great lesson to learn is you gotta believe in yourself even when nobody is believing in you, okay? So just go for it. If you have an idea, not always you can have an idea. Sometimes you can just look at the business and you can do it better than other people, do better business than other businesses doing it. You don't have to reinvent the wheel.
Thanks for tuning in. It was Zen Flint, the EntrepreneurMindPodcast.com.